Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Kannan. Welcome to the video on transposition of the humanist thought. The video will attempt to clarify the reason behind the decline of humanist thought in the early 20th century, which transposed itself into the anti-humanist thought. It is necessary to understand that anti-humanism is very critical to human thought in the European continent, and it was and still is mildly felt or seen in literature of the rest of the world. The reason lies in the historical events that had affected human thought in the early 20th century. And the major event responsible for it was the two great world wars that had happened in early 20th century. The anti-humanist thought had ruptured the entirety of human critical thinking that had existed before it, giving birth to modernism and postmodernism. The death of millions of people in the two world wars that came in quick succession had created an irrevocable loss among those that were living. It generally left people in despair and the thought that human life is futile. This was the same thought which led the critical thinkers of the 20th century look deep into the history of human thought and creation. Anti-humanist thought that prevails today had been very much influenced four people: Martin Heidegger, a philosopher; Charles Darwin, a biologist; Sigmund Freud, a psychoanalyst; and Friedrich Nietzsche, a philosopher. They were the starting point of a social theory which debased entire humanist thought. When common people were questioning human nature by analyzing the futility of human life, Heidegger, Darwin, Nietzsche, and Freud had ruptured humanist philosophy by their critical faculty in their own fields, which led to the emergence of modernism and postmodernism. Heidegger debased 2000 years of history and philosophy by questioning the very nature of being. According to him, existence or being is not merely the presence but the utility. Imagine a painter with his brush painting a picture. The painter may not concentrate on the brush until it serves its purpose of painting. But when it breaks, the existence of the brush takes a different mode, where the painter thinks about buying a new brush. If human life is substituted in the place of the brush, it could be argued from the stance of Heidegger, that the utility of human being is at all times relative to the idea of death, thus reducing the life of a person to the thought of being utilized as something before death, which exactly happens during the World War. Freud created a rupture in the humanist thought by delving deep into the minds of human beings, reduce the human psyche into three categories: id, ego, and superego, thus questioning yet again the human nature and its unpredictability of actions and desires at any given point of time. It would only mean that the moral or virtuous purposes that govern human mind, according to humanist thought, can really be distorted. Anti-humanist philosophers borrow the idea of Freud to scrutinize the damage humans have caused other human beings in history, which is a proof that human beings always have secret intent hidden underneath. Nietzsche famously remarked that God is dead. To express the disappearance of any system of values which had primarily happened due to the rationalization of everything in terms of science through humanist thought. So, the sentence should not be taken in the literal sense. Last but not least, Darwin debased the humanist thought using the evolution of human beings. It was believed previously that human beings were made in the image of God, thus allowing human beings to justify that they are superior than every organism in the planet. But Darwin brought a closure to that particular thought. He did that by systematically proving that human beings had actually evolved from apes and there is nothing special about them. It could be regarded as the master stroke in transposing humanist thought and seemingly an argument that could be comprehended without any complications. If not for these four critical thinkers, humanist thought had attempted and succeeded in putting man at the center of the world. Anthropocentrism is a fundamental underlying principle of humanism which can be seen in any humanist literature. May it be the poem Death Be Not Proud by John Donne, or Dr. Faustus by Christopher Marlowe, or the critical treatise The Advancement of Learning by Bacon, or the prose romance by Lady Mary Roth, or the 37 plays written by the literary genius William Shakespeare. The human perception of the world is in the center of all humanist literature. Today, at an eco-critical standpoint, the humanist thought has an adversity to the environment around it without placing any importance to the existence of other organisms on Earth. Hence, it became a necessity that the idea of human beings is overthrown metaphorically to dislodge man from the center. Thank you.